Let's focus on how to use the Ripple Trim Smart Tool function. To demonstrate Ripple Trim, let's take a look at where we left off from the last lesson.
Inside, they were doing work, and I believe it was a sewer hole. From the time the run came in until we got the victims out.
You'll notice that this shot of the ambulance runs a little too long. Instead of having to re-edit the clip, you can use the Ripple Trim function to shorten the segment. Off to the left side of the timeline, you will see the Smart Tools palette. Activate the yellow Ripple Trim function. Again, if you are new to Avid, I recommend that you only work with one Smart Tool at a time. So for now, make sure all these other Smart Tools are turned off. Also, to help me demonstrate Ripple Trim, turn on these clip durations within your clip segments. To do this, navigate to the Timeline Fast menu and choose Clip Text, Clip Durations. So now, move your cursor towards the end of the clip segment and wait for your cursor to turn into the yellow Ripple Trim icon. Then click on the edge of the clip. Make sure you see a yellow line at the end of your clip segment. Note, if you see two pink lines, you've changed into a different trim mode that I will cover later, so make sure the line is yellow. Now, you'll notice that the controls within the Composer window have changed. This is because by clicking on the edge of the clip with the Ripple Trim icon, it will take you into trim mode. When you are in trim mode, you are looking at the last frame of the outgoing clip segment versus the first frame of the incoming clip segment. So let's shorten this clip of the rescued worker going into the ambulance. Notice the duration of this segment is 6 seconds and 23 frames long. As you drag the yellow trim handles to the left, you will be shortening the clip segment. When you let go of the mouse button, the sequence will be shorter by the amount of time that you've trimmed away. Notice the new duration of the clip segment is now 3 seconds and 27 frames. Now, if you change your mind, as long as you still have the yellow trim handles, you can always add additional content by dragging the yellow handles the opposite way. Also, if you look at your keyboard, you can use these keys to perform the same trim function without having to drag the mouse. The M key and the forward slash key trim 10 frames at a time, and the less than and greater than keys trim 1 frame at a time. Now, when you are trimming clips, you can also trim from the front of a clip segment. So in this example, I'll trim the head of the clip segment so the paramedics are closer to the ambulance. Okay, after you've completed your trim, click in this gray timecode bar area to return to normal editing mode. Awesome, so let's watch part of the sequence again.
Inside, they were doing work, and I believe it was a sewer hole. From the time the run came in...
That's much better by trimming down that shot a bit. Now, an important side note. When trimming a clip segment that has sound attached to it, it's important that you trim the video and audio elements equally. The good news is, by default, the Avid will automatically select the audio and video elements for you, unless you turn off this link selection icon. So be careful, because if this link selection icon is turned off, it's possible to force your video and audio content out of sync. And if that happens, as indicated by these white frame indicators, you will want to undo your previous action. Okay, now you have the fundamentals of using the Ripple Trim function.